Hello, B here, and welcome back to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. We're starting today's lesson with a puzzle. What do all of these things have in common? It seems like a pretty motley assortment. Any guesses? Well, they all use or occur because of a specific type of wave that is the topic of today's lesson, electromagnetic waves. Do you recognize the two root words in electromagnetic waves? They are formed from a combination of electricity and magnetism. We'll find out today that they share characteristics with other types of waves we have studied, and that they are all around us every single day. Before we explore these waves further, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to define characteristics of electromagnetic waves and give examples of each type of electromagnetic wave. Imagine you're holding a rope. When you shake it up and down, waves travel along the rope, right? Electromagnetic waves, also commonly referred to as just EM waves, are similar, but instead of a rope, they consist of vibrating electric and magnetic fields. Electric and magnetic fields are like invisible forces around electric charges and magnets. When an electric charge vibrates or accelerates, it shakes up the electric field around it. This shaking creates waves, just like your hand creates waves in the rope. But here's the cool part. When the electric field waves shake, they create a magnetic field that shakes too. And this magnetic field then affects the electric field, creating a cycle. These fields are always perpendicular to each other. It's like a dance, with each field taking turns leading and following, creating a wave that travels through space. A few lessons ago, we learned about longitudinal and transverse waves. What category do you think EM waves fall into? Remember that one defining characteristic of transverse waves is that the particles of the medium move perpendicular to the motion of the wave. Electromagnetic waves do not need a medium, but use electric and magnetic fields instead. This concept of two entities moving perpendicular to each other classifies them as transverse waves. The ability of EM waves to travel without a medium means that they can move through the vast emptiness of space. This is fortunate for us because otherwise the sun's rays would not be able to reach us here on Earth. The light we receive from the sun is a type of electromagnetic wave. In fact, EM waves are often used synonymously with the term light waves. Do you have any idea how long it takes the sun's light to reach us? It takes about 8 minutes for a light ray to cross the 93 million mile distance between the Earth and sun. This means that the light from the sun must be traveling at a speed of over 11 million miles per minute. To help put that into perspective, imagine a single light wave traveling in a circle around Earth's equator. This light wave would circle the globe 7.5 times in a single second. World travel would be so much easier if our planes could do that. So, we now know that sunlight is an electromagnetic wave and that it is very fast. What about other types of light, like these light bulbs above me? Are they EM waves too? Yes! All types of light are electromagnetic waves, and all light travels at the same speed as sunlight. If not for EM waves, we wouldn't be able to see anything. But there are also types of electromagnetic waves that we can't see. Just like other transverse waves, EM waves can exist with different wavelengths and frequencies. And our eyes happen to be adapted to pick up frequencies of EM waves that fall in the medium range. Because electromagnetic waves can exist with an infinite number of wavelengths and frequencies, they are often thought of as a spectrum. This is known as the electromagnetic spectrum and is a way of visualizing the different types of possible EM waves, along with their unique characteristics. The spectrum is divided into 7 groups: radio waves, microwaves, infrared, visible light, UV, X-ray, and gamma. While it is common to see the spectrum presented in this way, it is important to note that no single wave would contain all of these wavelengths at once. A single wave will be one of these types, based on its wavelength. Let's take a tour of the entire spectrum. EM waves are also sometimes referred to as radiation. Radiation is often seen as something scary, but it's just another word for electromagnetic waves, or light in general. And it's happening all around us all the time. Even the light reaching your eyes from the screen this video is playing on is a form of radiation. As we go through the spectrum, we'll see which types of radiation are harmless and which we need to be more careful around. But in their own ways, all types of radiation are useful to us. Let's start with radio waves, the gentle giants of the EM spectrum. They have the longest wavelengths, some as long as a football field or even longer. These are the chatty waves that carry your favorite songs to the radio, the voice of a podcast host to your phone, and even the moving images to your television. They're like the post office of the EM world, delivering information over vast distances. And they're not just for sending music or shows. They also help pilots talk to air traffic controllers and ships communicate with ports. Next up are microwaves. A bit more energetic than radio waves with shorter wavelengths. These are the handy waves that cook your popcorn and heat up your leftovers. But it's not all about food. Microwaves are also the reason you can check the weather forecast. They bounce off clouds and rain to tell meteorologists what's happening in the skies. Microwaves are also crucial for point-to-point communication links and satellite communications. Moving on, we find infrared waves, which are all about heat. These waves are emitted by anything warm, including you. Infrared cameras can detect these waves, making them useful for night vision goggles used by campers or wildlife researchers to see animals in the dark. They're also the ones that make thermal imaging possible, which firefighters use to see through smoke. Your remote likely uses infrared waves to communicate with the TV, and they can be used in contactless thermometers. So far, all of the EM waves we have looked at have wavelengths longer than the visible radiation our eyes are capable of seeing. This means that these waves are generally not thought to be dangerous, because they have even less energy than visible light. Visible light waves are perhaps the most interesting part of the spectrum. They make this beautiful rainbow behind me and allow us to see all of the objects we use in our daily lives. But we'll look more closely at visible light in our next lesson. So for now, let's move on up to the types of radiation that carry more energy than visible light. Cranking up the energy, we meet ultraviolet rays, often called UV rays. The sun sends out these high-energy waves, which are invisible to us, but are what give you a tan or a sunburn if you're not careful. They're also the reason fluorescent materials glow in the dark when they're under a black light. Despite their bad rap for causing skin damage, they help our bodies make vitamin D, essential for healthy bones. And they can be used to sanitize equipment, because UV rays will kill most bacteria and viruses. Then there are X-rays, even more energetic than UV rays. They're like the super spies of the spectrum, able to pass through many materials that visible light can't. That's why doctors use them to look at bones inside your body, as bones are dense enough to block X-rays and show up as white on an X-ray image. However, being exposed to X-rays on a regular basis is known to increase your risk of cancer. So those that work around X-ray machines must take precautions to limit exposure. Finally, at the highest energy, we have gamma rays. Gamma rays are used by astronomers to study violent events, such as supernovas and black holes. These waves are so powerful, they're also used to treat cancer by killing cancer cells. Ironically, overexposure to gamma rays can also cause cancer. In nature, they are also produced as a product of radioactive decay. As we went through the lesson today, we learned that electromagnetic waves are transverse waves that have a vibrating electric and magnetic field. We then took a tour of the entire electromagnetic spectrum, seeing the kinds of waves that surround us every day. Be sure to take a look at the lesson PDF for some information on how you can protect yourself from some of the most dangerous EM waves. In the next lesson, we'll zoom in on the visible part of the electromagnetic spectrum and find out what determines the color we see for different objects. Until then, remember, the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. See you next time. Hey, hey.